You're here because you've narrowed down your search for a portable solar generator between the BlueTTI EB55 and the Ecoflow River Pro. The question is, which is the better unit? Let's find out. Hello, I am Wanderer 001, and this is my comparison or versus video for the BlueTTI and Ecoflow portable solar generators here. I do have individual full reviews up there in the corner. If you're looking for a deep dive into the full review of either of these, this is more of a quick hit comparison video to help you make an informed decision. So let's actually start with one of the biggest things, which is battery size. They will list this as watt hours. The BlueTTI over here has a watt hour of 537. The Ecoflow has a watt hour battery of 720. So this is actually the larger battery. However, we then look at output. So that's how much wattage you can get out of each individual unit. Starting again on the left with our BlueTTI, this has a maximum of 700 watts out with a surge of up to 1400 watts. Now, our Ecoflow right here has a maximum output of 600 watts with a maximum of 1800 surge using X boost, which is an interesting feature that most Ecoflow portable solar generators have, in that it will lower the voltage so that you can get more wattage out. Now, the only issue with this is if you're using something like a hairdryer or a heat gun, you're going to notice an audible change using X boost because that lower wattage means that the tool is not actually performing at 100%, as you can hear here. And heat gun with X boost. So low, which was no problem before, but now you can see I can do the high now without it tripping. Even with that feature, really have to give it to the BlueTTI for having the more output without having a fancy trick. Next thing is, well, what type of battery do you have? What is the battery makeup or chemical makeup of the battery? BlueTTI has been known for using their LiPo4, which has the distinct advantage of more charge cycles, meaning you can charge this battery 2,500 times before you'll notice any battery degradation to 80%. Our River Pro here uses a more commonly found lithium ion battery, which only has 800 cycles before you'll start seeing battery degradation to 80%. So again, in this particular instance, your BlueTTI has an advantage over Ecoflow. Next, let's talk about form and function. Both of these batteries sit at about 16.5 to 16.8 pounds. However, once you start including some of the other peripherals that you'll need to operate them, things get a little heavy really quick, meaning the power brick that you'll need to charge the BlueTTI with adds an extra 5 pounds. Cable that you need for charging the Ecoflow here barely adds any weight. Talking about those chargers, we're going to dovetail into two things. One is noise, and noise meaning fan noise. Each of these units has fans on the side of it, allowing it to cool. With the Ecoflow, you have a variable speed controller for the fan, and you can set it for I'd prefer quiet or I'd prefer maximum cooling. BlueTTI, you don't have that option. It's max fans all the time, and the chunky power brick that comes with it also has a fan that never turns itself off. In a quiet room, you will noticeably hear them, as you can see here. But with that extra fan noise, do you get extra charging capacity? Meaning, how quickly can I charge the units? Well, here's the thing. BlueTTI here takes 3 hours to fully charge. And this is the one that has the smaller internal battery. Our Ecoflow here takes 1 hour to get to 80% and roughly 2 to maximally charge, because this, using a single cable, has the ability to fast charge the unit. So if you're looking for something that can be charge in a short amount of time, this is definitely going to give the win to the Ecoflow here. And that is because the Ecoflow can have a maximum watt pull from your wall of up to 660 watts. BlueTTI, only 200. Now, these are both solar generators, so you can plug a standard solar panel into them. Both of the inputs on these are 200 watts max pulling from solar, so they're kind of tied there. BlueTTI does have a trick where you can both solar charge and charge from your wall at the same time, giving it an advantage over the Ecoflow. But if you're getting this, you're either, in my opinion, going to be solely charging it from the wall to speed charge it, or you're going to be using it outside to pull down solar, which in that case, they're tied for solar, and this one wins when utilizing it just for electrical. Zooming in a little closer, well, obviously, we're gonna talk about displays because that's important. The information that you get from these will let you know exactly what you have going on. Over here on the left, you have the BlueTTI, and what that's going to show you is right here, this is a giant battery cell that normally has 20% ticks, and that little red icon there means I am almost dead and need to charge this. However, there's still charge left in this, but I have no idea how much because this only breaks it down into 20% increments, as you could see. One of the things that I did not like about charging this was when I got up to the top, I did not know if it was actually done charging. Well, I did find out that the giant power brick that comes with the BlueTTI does turn green. There's a little red light on it that turns green when this is fully charged. The other things that you get with this, you have your input wattage and your output wattage. So that's kind of standard. I like seeing what I'm pulling and what I'm putting into the unit. Over here on the Ecoflow, not only do we have a battery percentage, we have input wattage, we have output wattage, and then you've got this large number right here, as well as this little circular icon around your percentage. Well, the circular icon, again, is a visual representation of how much battery is left in the unit. Over here, this 99 hours, this is actually going to give you a live runtime for whatever you have plugged into this. So if you plug a computer into this, you're gonna know exactly how many hours you could run that particular item for. Over here on BlueTTI, you don't get that feature. Both of them do support pass-through charging, so you will be able to have input going into the device to charge it, and then output power whatever device you're trying to use the actual solar generator for. Next, we're gonna cover form and function and some unique features of each battery. One thing I'd like to point out, the bright white light on the button for the Ecoflow is easy to see, and you have a solid button press. Over here on the BlueTTI, it's very light green, hard to see outside, and the buttons tend to be very jiggly. Also, screen time's out on this one. You can actually set your actual timeout for this particular one. And part of that is because Ecoflow has a companion app that you can have on your smartphone to control and make changes to how this functions. So that is a very unique feature that Ecoflow has. So not only can I make changes to the display, it also gets firmware updates. So in the future, if there's something that Ecoflow thinks they could do better with this, whether that's optimal fan speeds for temperature, or hey, maybe if I tweak this a little bit, you'll discharge a little slower and get to keep more of your battery. That's all done through the application and firmware updates that only Ecoflow has. BlueTTI, once you have it, you have it. That's it. Another unique feature of the Ecoflow is an expandable battery. So you can pretty much pick up something the same size as this, plug it in, and you will double the capacity of your Ecoflow battery. Now that is sold separately, but is again a distinct feature of the Ecoflow River Pro compared to the BlueTTI EB55. That is not to say that the EB55 does not have its own unique features, one being the lay flat handle. That is definitely something that you're gonna notice. This is a solid plastic piece that, while sturdy to help pick up and move around, you're not gonna really be able to pack this in as nicely as you would with this, which has the lay flat handle. Not only that, if I tilt the EB55 forward, you're gonna notice right up there, that is a wireless charging pad built into the top of that. That is a very unique feature in my opinion. And realistically, if Ecoflow moved the handle, there's a lot of space that they could have done something similar, but they did not. The last bit that I'm gonna talk about is the placement of the light. And I know that seems like a very trivial thing. However, the way that Ecoflows are designed, all of your information is on the front here. You do have your charging port and outlets on the side of it, but everything else is in the front, including your LED light. So if you're trying to use this, you gotta flip it around in order for the light not to shine in your face. However, on the EB55, the light is located on the back. So to me, that's actually a pretty good design idea so that it's not shining in your face. The last thing, and this is actually the last thing that I want to point out, is number of actual usable ports. So over here on the EB55, you have 4 electrical outlets, only 2 of which have a false grounding. On the Ecoflow, you have only 3, but each of them has the false grounding. Coming over to our USB style, you have 1 USB-C and then 4 USB-A. Over here, you have 3 USB-A and only 1 USB-C. You get more ports on the EB55 than you do with the Ecoflow River Pro. Question is, how usable are they? Because like I said, you only get 2 with the false grounding. So now that we've covered the major differences in a comparison between the two, final thoughts. Which one is the right one for you? I am not going to give a cop-out answer saying it's up to you. If I were to do this all over again and could only purchase one, because I do have both, if I could only purchase one again, I would go with the Ecoflow River Pro again, because this is a top-in-class display. It has the expandability. Yes, it's lithium ions. I'm not going to get as many cycles charging it as I would the EB55, but the display, the expandability, and the app that can constantly make it better, to me, make it the superior portable solar generator, especially if you're in a grid down situation and you need to know exactly how much time you have left on the device you have plugged into it. That makes this invaluable. Realistically, I kind of relegated this one to, I'll throw it outside, charge it up with my solar panel, and then I charge my phone, my camera batteries, all that off of this. But when I need to know how much time I have left in a power outage, I use this one. Hopefully that has helped you make some sort of decision as to which one is the right choice for you. Again, in the corner there, if you have any questions, I have in-depth reviews of both of these, so you should go check those out as well. With that being said, I have been Wanderer001. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them in the area below. And as always, thanks for watching.
If you found this video helpful, consider giving it a like, as that will help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here, you can always help fuel the next review by buying me a coffee, link in the description below. Last but not least, if you want to be notified when I upload a new video, you know what to do.